some chefs who explain the ayah in the Quran, who says, and they explain the hikmah as to use.
Al hikmah has many, it is used in different context. One of the meanings of al hikmah is wad'u al-shay fi mawdi'ihi. Wad'u al-shay fi mawdi'ihi. To put something in its proper place. Understand? And the sunnah is to put something in its proper place as well. So the sunnah is also al hikmah, and general advice and hikmah and wisdom is also hikmah. Do you understand the difference? So the word al-hikmah also includes the sunnah. In the Quran, where the word al-hikmah has been mentioned many times, it refers to the sunnah. In certain contexts that the word al-hikmah has been used, it refers to the hikmah, which is what was shay'i fi mawdi'ihi.
Okay, this is in Swahili, so I'm not gonna read it. Speak loud. Come here.
You will be a grown-up person if you go to Jannah. Everybody will be young in Jannah. Even if you're old, you will be young in Jannah. So you will go away. So don't worry. Insha'Allah, if you go to Jannah, you will be awake. Tilmidhi Sheikh Abdul Nasir will inshallah teach. Bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Khalas, I've appointed him. He's from your city. Do you understand? Ahlu Makkah adala bi shi'abiha. So, Sheikh Abdul Nasir inshallah will continue to teach. Bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Khalas, so we shall discuss something now. Alhamdulillah, we completed one book. And it is an amazing feeling for me that I have completed something. And I have completed it in this masjid. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless this masjid. And this masjid will be in my prayers, in my dua, whenever I remember to do so in my travelings, and when I am in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's masjid and in Riyadhul Jannah. I always will make dua for this masjid, and the brothers and the sisters who are responsible for this masjid, that they have facilitated for me to come and teach this book. Because believe me, that is, there is sometimes to give khutbas and to give seminars in masajid is difficult than getting an appointment with Theresa May at 10 Downing Street. Wallahi. And I say, Inni ushidun. I say this without mubalaka, bidun mubalaka. Sometimes to go and give and deliver a talk in some of the masajid, 3 to 4 to 5 weeks, the committee, we have to speak to the committee, the chairman is away, he's on holiday, this has happened, he's not available, we are going to, subhanallah, ya akhi, we only want to come and give da'wah. We only want to come and teach the people. Nothing else. Understand? Ila hadhihi daraja, what are you going to teach? How long is it going to be? We need to look at the context. Subhanallah. And these people, they have no idea, and they have no knowledge about Islam. And this is unfortunately the reality of the Muslims of today. Illa man rahimallah. I don't say we don't masajid. Many of the other masajid are welcoming, but we have had issues. And this is the problem. Or you find that you want to go give a lecture in a masjid, and there is somebody else who is teaching in the masjid that is not qualified to do so, and there is now tanafus between you and him. You know, he's trying to, he's fearing now that you will take over his position. We don't want to take over nobody's position. We don't want to take over your masjid. We just want to come and teach and go and advise. This is our objective. Why we have no other objective. So it makes me feel very happy, alhamdulillah, that this masjid, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep the masjid upon this manhaj that they facilitate for the brothers and the sisters. And this letter from the sisters, it brings happiness and joy in my heart, and it makes me cry as well. Because it shows me that there is a hunger and a thirst for knowledge in this masjid. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from this masjid create ulama of Ahlul Sunnah that will go and spread Dawah Salafiyya in the four corners of England and in the world. So I thank once again the committee of this masjid. Once again, Man lam yashkur innas lam yashkur illah. The one who is not grateful to the people cannot be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward this masjid for facilitating for such a topic. And like I said, we need to study the books of Tawheed. We need to study the books of Sunnah. We need to study about Salah. We need to study about Zakah. We need to study about Sawm. We need to study about cleansing of our hearts. We need all this, but along with Tawheed. When we study this all with Tawheed, we will understand it correctly. Barakallahu feekum. So Sheikh Abdul Nasir will continue bi idhnillahi ta'ala teaching you in this masjid.
Barakallahu feekum, jazakallahu khair. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our dear Sheikh Zulfiqar Maymoon Ibrahim Hafidhahullah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase him in knowledge and to bless him and to put barakah in his knowledge and in his health and his life and prolong his life upon faith. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make him of those who are dua to the religion, accordance to the religion. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned them in the Quran, Rabbaniyun, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our dear Shaykh from them. And Rabbaniyun, as it came, and the scholars made tafsir, an explanation of it, they are the one who teach Sigar al-ilm qabla kibari. They teach the small, beneficial, necessary, basic knowledge before the major. And our dear Shaykh, alhamdulillah, may Allah bless him, we witness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he did that. He taught us Tawheed, we benefited from him, and he taught us aspects of this. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward him with Jannah for his effort. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward you all for your patience and for your attentiveness. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who hear this speech and act by it and benefit from these beneficial lessons of Tawheed. Inshallah, our dear Sheikh has promised us that in the lab there will be certificate of attendance for those who attended. So inshallah, please, again, as I said, write your name for the brothers and sisters. Inshallah, we will print them out and give you to them the next time we will meet with Nilah. Also, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward the committee of the masjid for allowing such lessons and reminders to happen. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward everybody for coming and taking the time out, especially our young children, our young brothers. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect them from every fitna and to keep them upon Tawheed until they die. Jazakumullah khair.
Barakallahu feekum. Inshallah, we will print the certificates out, inshallah, put the masjid logo and Ahmad Sunnah logo, and inshallah, the certificates will be given for those who have registered their names, everybody that attended, from the young to the old, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. And Sheikh Abdul Nasir will inshallah facilitate for this. Inshallah, we'll try to do this as soon as we're able to do so. And bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, we hope that inshallah, in the next visit, my next visit, inshallah, we will study the book Sharh Usul al-Iman of Sheikh Muhammad al-Masari al-Taymi, rahimahullah ta'ala, or another small text, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, for jazakumullah khairah. And this will be written in my diary, which I have written, alhamdulillah, from the cherishing moments of my journey, 2018, when I go back to the scholars of Medina, when I will sit with them, when I will mention to them about the masjid of Ahlul Sunnah, and I will speak with them, and I will, inshallah, discuss with them in detail with regards to this masjid itself and how this masjid is trying to facilitate and striving and working hard to spread the manhaj of Ahlus Sunnah. Today I was informed of certain events which I did not know with regards to this masjid. Historically that happened here, and I heard and I found out that there was a split that happened a little while ago, and the reason of why that split happened was only because the masjid was upon the Sunnah, and those who wanted to unite with them were not united upon the Sunnah. So the brothers who are responsible in this masjid said that we would not negotiate on these principles. Either we shall split and we shall part our ways, and we shall not be able to work together, because our manhaj is the manhaj of Ahlus Sunnah. This was something very greatly informed to me today, and I was extremely happy, and I noted this down. As you see that I always carry a small notebook wherever I go, and then I write this down. So this will all be, inshallah, delivered to the scholars. And if those scholars ever visit this masjid, ever visit the UK, in my absence or in my presence, they will say to me, take me to that masjid. So I'm pretty sure that if any of the scholars that I know come to Medina, first thing that they will want to see, inshallah, visit are the brothers of Ahlus Sunnah in this masjid.
Inshallah, just as a quick reminder, all lessons are recorded on, and they are found on Facebook. Whoever wants to listen to them and recap them with his family and his children, inshallah, just write your phone number and your contact number, inshallah, and we add you to a da'wah group that we make specifically for the da'wah in Coventry. Inshallah, and you will be updated with anything that goes along specifically with this masjid or any masjid in regards to Coventry that is upon Sunnah, inshallah. And some of it are also on YouTube. There was only two lessons, which is today's lesson and the first lesson ever of this course. They will be on YouTube on a channel called the Coventry Faith Foundation Da'wah channel. Now. بارك الله فيكم، جزاكم الله خير، مع السلامة عليكم، سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت.